My name's Alan Hart, and today I'm going to look at a new control for Boiler Plus. So this is a new control that will comply with your Boiler Plus regulations, and this is the ESI control. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open it up and I'm going to have a look inside, see what I think to it. Now this is the first one I've seen. I've not opened the box yet, so I'm going to open it up and I'm going to give you my first opinion of it. And then what we're going to do then is we're going to install it onto this Baxi 600 boiler here, and then we'll set it up and see what we think of it. I do welcome feedback from anybody who is installing these already. So if you're already installing these, I'd really be grateful. Add some comments below and let us know what you think to it. So let's have a look now. So first of all, I'd like to thank Spinks in Leeds, the plumbers merchants. They've provided this control for me to do a review on. Right then, so let's have a look inside the box. So what do we get? Instructions. Some more instructions. The controller. Some batteries. Not in there. The receiver. Looks like it's got a standard style backplate. We'll have a look at that in a minute. Some fixing screws. And then a stand, so that must clip on the stand. So as always, I'd advise you to read the instructions. If you're going to be installing quite a few of these, then if you read the instructions first time, then at least you'll be fitting them right from day one. So yeah, read the instructions, most important thing of all. So if we have a look in the instructions here, it just tells you we need to be 1.5 meters high. So I've undone the two screws out of the back plate, lift the back plate off, and then I'm just going to fit the back plate on here. So this is only for demonstration purposes. I'll be taking this back off afterwards. So we've isolated the boiler, we've done his electrical checks, so always make sure that you're competent if you're going to be working on gas, and also if you're going to take the case off a boiler, you need to be gas safe registered. So let's have a look inside now. So at the moment in this Baxi 600, we've got it connected via open firm, so we've got a Nest thermostat on this at the moment. So I'm going to disconnect this, and then we're going to connect our new control into this. So if we have a look here, we've got live, we've got neutral, we've got zerf, and then we've got switch wires here. Them switch wires we're going to put in here because this control works off TPI. So we'll have a look at that now. So we've got a letter N there, so that's for us neutral. Got a letter L, that's for us live, and then we've got us common there, which is number one. That goes back to boiler. You can link these in some cases. I always try and feed it directly from boiler if I can. And then you got number two, which is normally open. And then this is just a mess at the moment because this is going to be getting taken back out in a few minutes after we've finished this video. But there is two wires there, which are the number one and the number two there. So that's just your normal link that you'd have in a combi. And then in this case, we've got us live and we've got us neutral and we've got us earth from the boiler as well. So there's a cutout section at bottom of here for the wires, and then the receiver just clicks on to there. And then for purpose of this video, I'm going to put the clock here. So it does come with a stand as well, but I'm just going to put it on the wall here, and then we can see it working together when we fire it up. So the programmer, that's wireless, and it gives you the option, so you can fit onto a stand, or you can fit it on the wall if you like. And then it comes with batteries, so I'm just going to put these batteries into here now. So we've put the batteries in there now, and then we're going to turn the power on to this. So at first glance, we've got time and date, we've got program, off, manual and auto. So I'm just going to have a little look in the instructions now. I'm just going to have a little read up, and then we'll come back and we'll have a little play with this. So if we put it onto time and date there, we can adjust the time. So it's the time is correct. So we'll just leave that. Also the day is correct as well, but we can do that with settings on here. And then if you do across on the bottom there, which is a little bit faffy, but it's okay. We can do program to set your program, and then off. So if you just want to turn it off, and then manual, if we put it onto manual there, we can turn it up and down with these. So if you see there, it says what the set point is, what we want to set it to, and that tells us what the temperature is in here at the moment. So if we just scroll that up, so we can boil a fire up. Don't know if you heard that click then, and there, boiler's firing up. Turn that back down, we don't want that on. It's already too warm in here. So when you first look at this, the cover doesn't stay down. So what you've got to do is you've got to pull that cover off front of it. And then it goes down then. But this is the ESI wireless programmable room thermostat, and it's about £40. For £40, it also complies with Boiler Plus. I don't think you can go wrong with it for £40, to be honest. It looks okay. Obviously it'll depend on how reliable they are going forward, but this is TPI as well. So yeah, it looks good. I'm quite impressed with it, to be honest. Some of it feels a little bit cheap, like that on there. It's got like a little line there, which is a little bit hard to see, but for £40, you can't fault it, I don't think, to be honest. So that's as ESI programmable room thermostat, which is wireless and it complies with Boiler Plus. So all in all, my opinion so far, obviously I've not installed them on customers' houses yet, so I don't know how reliable they will be going forward, but I think they look good, they look okay, they look value for money, and I don't think there's anything on the market that's anywhere near that price for the functions that this does. It also has advanced settings in there as well, which I'm going to play with a bit later. But thanks for watching, hope this video was of some use to somebody. Thank you.